In Honest Ways. Book by Kelvin Sulugwe. Chapter 8. The Fyson Lessons. At all cost, you should thrive to be talented or educated, but most importantly, be both talented and educated. You will go places. The places such art forms will take you are beyond even your own thought. They will be places with people you would never even dream of talking to or being in the same room with. There are those who admire to go outside Malawi, whether as migration or just touring. I find education and talent to be the easiest way to travel around the world. Your craft, gifts, abilities, priorities and everything you work to invest on will lead you to far better places. Believe that. There are a lot of scholarships out there looking for those with passion in education to tap into. Great universities all over the world have special places for international students, most of whom come under different scholarships. Some take them for granted, but to those who are scholars, having a higher education is what they have desired and longed for all their lives. As much as the world is twisted, there are still some good people that exist out there. There are people who just want to see others through. It makes them happy as much as it pushes those who they help into a world of possibilities, into the world of chance. Chance is what most people lack, the ability to just have a platform or a domain where they just prove themselves. Simultaneously, there are also a lot of gigs such as festivals looking for talents to be part and parcel of their performing lineups. Bottom line, strive at all costs to know your talents and if you have a chance, perfect your art through school. You can never be wrong. The world does not need one issue of the arts going against the scholars. We need both, for balance. The best that can happen to both is accepting who they are. The artist who has accepted themselves for the person who they really are, one that has taken the truth in themselves for what they do, will often prosper. This is because their craft would not go unnoticed if it is genuine. Genuine art is important. It shows that the artist is what they are. The world notices that without such a person doing this and that, then there would not be this and that. This is the approach one ought to take. If you do not do or play your role, then things would go wrong. That is why the students who are always acing their exams feel bad when they get a 98% instead of a 100%. It is internal and as Malalians, most of the people thrive for education. Does it not help? Because it's the same money that has paid for the fees that the graduates in Malawi incur. The same graduates are the ones whom will use the same tax money we pay on a daily basis to build our country. They will be the doctors whom give us the right medicine in the hospitals we go to when we are sick. They are the same people whom we look up to for protection when we feel threatened and afraid in the middle of the night and call for their police services. The same artists are the ones whom we look into for entertainment, for decorating our homes with their paintings and for the tailor-made clothes that we wear to our friends' weddings when they are exchanging vows. We say the richest people in the world are people who did not go far with school. However, we forget to also remind each other that the poorest people in the world are those who did not go far with school. The only difference is that the rich ones can be counted while the poor ones cannot be counted. They are just too many. We cannot ignore the setup of events. There are people that are born into war. They know nothing than the sound of gunshots and bombs blasting through their environment every now and then. There is you, born in a nation that has not seen war since the world wars and since the fights for freedoms, if you are old enough to have been there. And you come up with so much excuses, surpassing even the ones who were born in war and sickness, and you want to quit on the first day of your path. Get that education, learn and practice your craft on a daily basis. As such, by doing what we must to achieve our goals, we cannot completely disarm education in as far as success is concerned. It is a valuable asset to maintain what we need to know and to understand how some of our associates work. I ever heard of the late president whom would always study the field of discipline that the next person he is meeting with is into. If it's meeting a financial minister, he would have studies economics and finance before the meeting to fully understand what the minister would have to entail in them. If he was to meet with a person in health, he would study what they know, their discipline and specialty in order to understand medicine and how the whole health system works. Did it mean he had to study all those other careers just because he had to? No. He had to study them to understand another person's perspective and to know how best to use his power and thus produce the right outcome. Look at it in this way. Most Malayan farmers use a hoe to dig the ground and plant seeds for both commercial and personal consumption. This has been the norm for ages, but with technology, more successful farmers have adopted machines to help them in their farming. Education is like machinery to farming. It makes the whole farming success much easier than the traditional means. That is what education does to people. While it is no guarantee to one's success, but it brings individuals closer to the finishing line and gives them an advantage to start up in their quest to financial freedom. That is why, all successful people, uneducated ones included, end up employing educated people to manage their wealth. In whatever you do, do not shun school and try to be educated to understand the dynamics of your financial interests.